So David asks, how do you fix a slow Mac? I'm gonna assume that you've already watched the video where I talk about how to get rid of the spinning beach ball and some of the keyboard shortcuts around that. I'm gonna talk more about the actual problems that actually cause a slow Mac. Problem number one, the first and biggest, most common problem, is that you have had multiple Macs. You've had like 3 or 4 or 5 Macs, and with each new one that you get, you do the like automatic import where you suck everything from the old Mac into the next one, and then everything from that one into the next one. You like migrate. This is basically like moving from an old house to a new house and taking everything with you, including the dust and the cobwebs and all of the problems that the old house had. So the best way to fix that is to actually back up your Mac completely and maybe get help with this. Back it up completely, erase the hard drive completely, and do a clean system install and manually and specifically put only the stuff back in there that you use. And then you end up with this great, lean, mean machine that is perfectly tailored to you and your life. It's an amazing fix for any machine. The second thing that it often is an app or something running in the background. Sometimes it's even like a tab in Safari or in Chrome that's running rampant, and it's basically just using a ton of resources. And you can check this from Activity Monitor if you sort by CPU usage. The thing that bumps up to the top, if it's like 80, 90, 100% CPU usage, that'll be the thing that's like wasting all of your resources. So you can either quit that app, sometimes you might need to force quit it. Sometimes it's even good to just wait and see, like sometimes it'll sort itself out. The third thing is if you are running low on storage, you wanna always keep enough space. It's doing automatic stuff in the background, reading and writing information. So you wanna have lots of space available for that. Number four is if you actually have one of the older style of hard drives that actually has the spinning platter and the moving parts. You can check this just by going to the Apple menu and then About This Mac, and then click on Storage. And if your Mac is like anywhere from 2 to 4 years old, it can be a really great candidate for a solid state hard drive upgrade, or it's also called a flash drive. And this is basically like putting a Porsche engine into your Honda. Everything will be way faster. It'll read and write information way faster, and it'll feel like a new machine, and it's super satisfying. Number five, and this is a more extreme case, if you have a dying hard drive. In some cases, a hard drive will actually get stuck trying to read information, and you'll see that as, on your Mac, the beach ball will go for like a minute or 2 minutes, like a really long time. That could be bad blocks. In a case like that, it's really important to make sure that your Mac is being backed up, so do a Time Machine backup, and then just get it into a shop and have them run a hard drive scan to see what's going on, because it might be a more serious problem, and the worst thing is data loss. So make sure you can get backup. That's something that we, my team, can help with as well. We've done a whole lot of helping with those kinds of issues. So I know that's a lot of info. Hopefully that's helpful. And of course, reach out anytime, because if you've got a slow Mac, we know how it's going to affect your mood, your productivity, and your efficiency at doing all the stuff that you want to be doing. If you dug that and you want more, head to macandhome.com/killertips to grab your free ebook, The Top 10 Killer Tips to Speed Up Your Mac Without Spending a Dime. It's in human language with no acronyms.
Huge.
Huge. Huge!